Hoi hoi everybody, it's Sasha here. Hi, and guess what? It's time again for another amazing wisdom bubble. And just as promised, I am back to bring you more thoughts on reframing. Because you know what? We control our perception, and our perception controls our reality, which means we control our reality. And I'm going to be talking every week about reframing, at least for the next while. So today, I wanted to talk about reframing self-worth. And I'm going to talk about true self-worth, because I see a lot of people, they're talking about their self-worth, and they're measuring things like how much money they make and what they own. And that's usually where I kind of pause, because true self-worth is something that you measure without any external factors. Right? If you actually want to measure your self-worth, you have to exclude anything that is not yourself. So how much money you have, hey, that's not yourself. How can you be proud of that? Right? True self-worth comes from within. So when we look and we say, okay, well, what am I worth? When we reframe the concept of worth to be completely internal, that will change the dynamic entirely. Right? Because we're looking at our qualities, at our inherent values, at the core of ourselves, as opposed to what we may or may not be able to accomplish, what we may or may not own or achieve, right? So I manage my self-worth by doing a little exercise. So I want to share it with you today. Now, this is how I reframe self-worth in the moment. So when I'm really struggling with that whole, I'm not good enough because I'm not making enough money, albeit that doesn't happen as often these days. But if I'm struggling with a concept like I'm not good enough today because I didn't put on makeup, then I can run through this little exercise, right? So it's my favorite exercise. It's called stop, drop, and roll. So it's how you're going to reframe self-worth. And stop, drop, and roll is something you can do on the fly, simple to remember. So when you're doing an internal self-worth check, when you're battling these feelings of inadequacy and unworthiness, you're going to stop, drop, and roll. Okay? So stop comparing yourself to others and comparing yourself to other things. So stop comparing yourself is really the point, right? Because self-worth doesn't need comparisons. Then you're going to drop your inner critical voice. That little me, just drop kick that thing right out of there. And then three, you roll into your inherent worth. So that's where you start looking internally and figuring out what internally am I feeling? What is my actual worth to myself? And that's really who matters. So you're looking at things like intelligence and compassion, your ability to reason, your ability to improve, right? Inherent values that preside in every human life, right? So building your worthiness and reframing this concept of self-worth is really about measuring yourself on your own abilities and your own inner meters. It's completely personal. So the next time you're starting to feel imposter syndrome creep up, or you're feeling that you are not worth enough because of something that you have not achieved, I want you to take 2 seconds and stop, drop, and roll. And I promise you, you're going to feel better, especially if you do it again and again and again and again. Because your self-worth should not depend on external factors. Your self-worth is you. And you have a lot to offer to the world. So stop, drop, and roll. I dare you.